Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So today we'll move to another example on mesh current analysis. It is a three mesh example, four mesh example actually. Okay. Mesh number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. There are four meshes. We'll look into what is the possibility to solve the multiple mesh examples at our end of study. See, using calculator or using manual mathematical techniques, it is easy up to if I get a three equation system. It will yield 3x3 matrix, and we can go at the solution very comfortably. Now the moment 4x4 matrix arise, how to solve it? It is a bit difficult. Okay, for manual calculations we generally don't go for or if the number of meshes are above 3, generally we don't go with manual calculations. Either we will go with the programmed tool or we will go with the simulation tool. That way we will move at. Okay, but here what the thing is, there is mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3, mesh 4. Okay, so when we get into this kind of situation, observe whether we can reduce the circuit by either source shifting or source transformation. Is it possible for me to reduce the circuit? Or in the fourth mesh, you can observe there is a current source in the perimeter of the mesh. Okay. One thing we should remember that in any mesh, if a current source is existing, in the perimeter, in the perimeter of that mesh, such that current source is not common element between two meshes. Okay. Now suppose there is a current source present in any mesh in its perimeter such that that current source is not common between any two meshes. So here 10 amperes is not common between any two meshes. It is existing in the perimeter of this upper mesh. Okay. Then the value of that mesh current is the value of current source. Okay. Now suppose I have a mesh like this. Now suppose I have a current source of 2 amperes. This is say 10 volts. This is 1 ohm, 2 ohm and 3 ohm, for example. Then I will take this as I1. Okay. Then I will take this as I2. Now what is I2? I2 is the mesh current flowing in the second mesh. 2 ampere is the mesh current flowing in the second mesh. So therefore, what is I2 is equals to minus 2 amperes, because direction of I2 and direction of 2 amperes is opposing each other. So I2 is equals to minus 2 amperes. Then there will be only one equation. Substitute that into I2 into that equation, you will get I1. This is I1. So we will see such examples. Okay. Because there is one mesh current with current source, I have added this just for a note. Okay, this is a note. Now we'll go to this solution. Now it is possible to do this, considering one mesh current equals to the source value of 10 amperes going ahead. Second possibility is reduce the circuit to three mesh circuit. See, here it is asked, using mesh current analysis, find the currents in all elements. Okay, I want the current in all elements. Now 10 ohm is in third mesh as well as in fourth mesh. If I convert 10 ampere 10 ohm into voltage source, this 10 ohm is still present in the circuit in the third mesh. So I will not consume this 10 ohm in any way. Hence, if I reduce this circuit to three mesh circuit also, there is no harm. Okay. So what I do is, here I will write, okay, transform 10 ampere 10 volts, sorry, 10 ampere 10 ohms current source into voltage source. Okay. So I have to redraw the circuit. This is 120 volts, 8 ohms, 13 ohms, 4 ohm, 3 ohms, and this is 10 ohm, this 10 ohm as it is, this is 5 ohms as it is. Now this is the voltage source. So the voltage value is 10 into 10, 100 volts. I will not do it in detail. We already know this. And the direction of current source is from right to left. Therefore, the polarity of voltage source will be right terminal will be positive, left terminal will be negative. Okay. We can further reduce the circuit by taking the effective value of 10 ohm and 15 ohm, 5 ohms. Okay. So this is 120 volts, 8 ohms, 13 ohms. This is 10 plus 5, 15 ohms. This is 4 ohm. This is 3 ohm. The direction is upward. This is 100 volts. Now we have got a circuit with three meshes, and we can now apply the mesh current analysis method, okay, to solve this. So first, what is the first step? Identify the meshes. So there are three meshes. Let me name the corners C, D, E, F, G, H. Now, how many unknown currents will be there?
3.
3 unknown currents will be there. Now I have 3 meshes. Mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3. Okay. So now I have identified the meshes. Now assign the individual mesh currents, one mesh current to each mesh. Okay. So this is I1. Let this be I2. And let this be I3. Okay. I told that always I will be taking the clockwise direction mesh currents. Fine. Now we know the polarities, the direction of the mesh currents in each element. I can mark the polarities accordingly. So I1 is flowing through 8 ohms. The terminal where the current is entering is terminal A of 8 ohms. So that terminal will be at higher potential, B is at lower potential. The same I1 is flowing through 4 ohms in mesh 1. So it will be positive and negative across 4 ohm in mesh 1. I2 is flowing through 4 ohms in mesh 2. With respect to I2, polarity is plus and minus. I2 is flowing through 13 ohms from left to right. So left terminal is positive, right terminal is negative. I2 is flowing through 3 ohms from top to bottom in mesh 2. Top terminal is positive, bottom terminal is negative. I3 is flowing through 3 ohms from bottom to top. So bottom terminal is positive, top terminal is negative in third mesh. I3 is flowing through 15 ohms from left to right. Left terminal will be positive, right terminal will be negative. Polarities of the voltage sources are already given and that it is marked. Okay. So we recognized the meshes, we assigned the current, then we marked the polarity. Now we have to apply KVL to each mesh. Okay. We can write first one is apply. KVL to mesh 1. What is that mesh? A, B, G, H, A. Apply KVL to mesh 1, A, B, G, H, A. Okay. What is the equation? I1 is flowing through 120 volts. The direction of I1 is from H to A. And the polarity from H to A is rising. The potential from H to A is rising. So therefore, it is plus 120 volts. In the direction of the trace, if you face positive sign, you take negative. If you take negative sign, you take positive. Okay. So plus 120. What about 8 ohms? Current I1 is flowing through 8 ohm. It is a voltage drop. Okay. Therefore, it is minus 8 I1. Current I1 is flowing through 4 ohms. And also I2 is flowing through 4 ohms. Therefore, it is a voltage drop minus 4 into, and we are in the mesh 1 now, therefore it is I1 minus I2. I2 is opposing I1 when I am standing in mesh 1. So there are 3 terms in the equation, there are 3 elements in mesh 1 equals to 0. Okay, now open the brackets. It is 120 minus 8 I1 minus 4 I1 plus 4 I2 is equals to 0, or it is 12 I1 minus 4 I2 is equals to plus 120. Now this is equation 1. Okay. Or if you want, You can write this equation one as 12 I1 minus 4 I2 plus
0 I3
is equals to 120. It is just for your understanding, okay? 0 I3. Why it will come 0? Because see, there is no common element between mesh 1 and mesh 3. That is the only reason. Simple understanding. Okay. See, if the coefficient of I3 is 0 in any equation, it means there is no common element between mesh 1 and mesh 3. It means mesh 1 and mesh 3 are not in physical contact directly. They are not adjacent. Something is there in between them. Now, next. Apply KVL to mesh 2. What is mesh 2? BC, GF, B. Yeah. Can anybody tell me the equation?
-13 I2.
-13 I2.
-3 × I2 minus I3.
-3 × I2 minus I3. Yes, because we are in mesh 2, it is I2 minus I3.
-4 × I2 minus I1.
-4 × I2 minus I1. Exactly.
Is equal to 0.
Equals to 0. Okay. Now, if you rearrange the terms, what I get is, -4 I1 plus 20 I2 minus 3 I3 is equals to 0. This is equation 2. Just check, all are getting the same. Yes. And RHS of the equation will be 0 because there is no voltage source in the loop or in the mesh. It is understood. RHS of the equation will come into picture only when there is voltage source in that mesh. Okay. RHS of the equation 2 is 0 for mesh 2 because in mesh 2, if you observe, there are only 3 resistors. Therefore, there will be only 3 drops. Okay. Yeah. Is the equation correct? All are getting the same?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, next, apply I'll write it here because circuit is visible easily. KVL to mesh 3, it is CDEFC. Okay. Now I will write the equation. You just tell me whether it is right or wrong. Okay, you write from the one, I will write the final equation. Don't just copy. Okay. 0 I1 minus 3 I2 plus 18 I3 is equals to -100. Equation 3. Now tell me whether it is right. You write the equation like we wrote here, and tell me after you get the final, taking out the brackets, you will get this value.
We are getting same, sir.
Yes, all are getting the same equation.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
yes, sir.
Yes, okay. So I will write it here. -3 × I3 minus I2 minus 15 into I3 minus 100 is equals to 0. From this you got this, is it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Now, what is next step? Solving equation 1, 2, and 3. Simple. Solve. Solve equation 1, 2 and equation 3. So with that I will get I1 I will get I2 and I will get I3. A3 0 minus 3 plus 18 is equals to minus 100. Yeah, what is I1?
Ten point four two amps.
I2 is 1.28 amps. And I3 is minus 5.34 amps. All are getting same?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see the value of I3 is negative. What does this mean?
The actual current flows in
the third current I3 is in anticlockwise direction. That is only understanding. You should understand and leave it. Okay. You need not to do anything else with that. Now, it is also asked to find out the current in all the components. Find currents in all elements and voltage drop across 4 ohms and 3 ohms. Okay. Current in all elements. Okay. So, what are the elements here? I 120 volts, I 8 ohms. I 4 ohms, I 13 ohms, I 3 ohms, I 15 ohms, and I 100 volts. Okay, so I 120 volts is nothing but the current
I1.
It. Yeah, I 120 volts. 120 volts is in the perimeter of mesh 1 and it is not also common between any meshes. So therefore, current through 120 volt source is I1, which is equals to 10.42. I 8 ohms is also on perimeter of mesh 1. The current through that is I1. Later stage you can write directly, but you should follow this. First, to make your fundamentals strong in understanding the concepts, then you can directly apply I atoms, I1, I atoms, directly you can write the values also. There is no harm. Now, I 4 ohms. 4 ohms is between mesh 1 and mesh 2. Okay. So, the current flowing through 4 ohms is the resultant of I1 and I2. Now, by observing the value of I1 and I2, I1 is 10.42, I2 is 1.28. I1 is greater than I2, therefore I 4 ohms is I1 minus I2. Okay, because I1 is greater than I2, so it is I1 minus I2. So I1 is 10.42 minus 1.28 equals to how much?
9.14 amps.
9.14 amps. Okay. Next, I 13 ohms. It is in the perimeter of mesh 2, uncommon to anything else. So it is I2. 1.28 amps. I 3 ohms. In I3, again 3 ohm is common between mesh 2 and mesh 3. Therefore, the net current flowing through 3 ohms is the resultant of I2 and I3. Now, by observing the value of I2 and I3, I2 is 1.28, I3 is minus 5.34. Which one is larger? Obviously, okay. 1.28 is larger than minus 5.34 amps. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Because minus 5.34 amps is a clockwise current. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Minus 5.34 is a clockwise current. I2, 1.28 is also a clockwise current. So when I have to take the resultant of two clockwise currents in a common element, okay, it will be larger minus smaller. So one clockwise current is 1.28, other clockwise current is minus 5.34. 1.28 is larger than minus 5.34. So therefore, it is I2 minus I3. Again, because I2 is greater than I3. Okay, equals to 1.28 minus of minus 5.34.
Six point six two amps.
Now, if you mark the exact direction of this I3 is minus 5.34, considering IC to be clockwise. Now, if I mark exact direction of the current, okay, which is anti-clockwise, minus I3. Now see, I2 is flowing from top to bottom in 3 ohm. Minus I3 is also flowing from top to bottom in 3 ohms. So when two currents will enter from the same terminal in any element, the currents will add up. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Same thing happened here. So physically also it is correct. Mathematically also it is correct. Analytically also it is correct. Mathematically if you see the process, it is correct. If you see mathematics, it is also correct. Okay, so whenever you are adding, subtracting, multiplying any currents, any voltages, please don't forget to include along with this sign. Okay, that will be important. Now I 15 ohms is again I3, which is minus 5.34 ohms. Okay. I 100 ohms I3, which is minus 5.34 ohms. Amps, sorry, not ohms. Now I need to find the voltage drop between 4 ohm and 3 ohm. Okay. That is also in the question. So V 4 ohm is equals to, it is I1 minus I2. Into 4. V 3 ohm is equals to I2 minus I3. So I 4 ohms is 9.14. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
9.14 into 4 equals to, it is 36.56. Is it?
Yes, sir.
This is I 3 ohms is 6.62 into 3 equals to
19.86 volt.
Okay, so this is the solution. Okay, this is the solution. Any doubts? Any clarifications you need? Yes?
No, sir, it's clear.
No, sir.
Okay?
No, sir.
Fine. Now we'll take another example. Okay? And we'll see how to write the equations just by observing the circuit. Okay? Example 3. Find the current through 24 ohms using mesh current analysis. In the circuit shown. Now this is a circuit given. Okay. Now we'll try to write the mesh equations by inspection method. Okay. There is no specific what we can say method like inspection method or by a fundamental method. Inspection method is one of the shortcut to write the KVL equations. Okay. Now, all of you are having notes along with you, or no? In that, it is not.
Yes, sir.
Okay. No, it is anyway. It is not there in that. Let us write KVL equation by inspection. This is useful without knowing how to write the KVL equations using inspection. You cannot get the circuit from the equations. Now, in previous examples and in this example, I am getting equations from the circuit. Okay, you may be asked to find the circuit using equations also. Okay, you should be knowing that also. Okay. Now, what we should do in inspection method? We should first observe how many meshes are there and how they are interconnected. Okay. How many meshes are there here? Can anybody tell?
Three
meshes. Okay. So A, B, C, D, E. Sorry, E, F, G, and H. Okay, so mesh 1, you can give any number mesh 1. Okay, there is not compulsion that only we have to travel from mesh left to right. So I will take this as mesh 1, I will take this as mesh 2. And I will take this as mesh 3. Am I audible and visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, there is continuous power cut, so this discontinuity is there. Screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Window is visible? Okay. So mesh 1 is A, B, H, F, G, A. Okay. Mesh 2 is B, C, D, H, B. Mesh 3 is H, D, E, F, H. Okay. Now, see, ultimately, the values of resistances are the coefficients of unknown currents. Okay. And the values of voltages are the values of RHS. You can observe in the previous example, you can see here. If you observe the equations, the coefficients are nothing but the sum of resistors, is it? In mesh 1, 4 ohm, this is 4 plus 13 plus 3 ohm, this is 3 ohm. So, coefficients of equations are the resistance values, RHS are the voltage values. Okay, you should remember that. In KVL equation, Coefficients are register values. Okay. And RHS are EMF values. Okay, RHS are EMF values. Okay. Now, how to write KVL equation in mesh 1? Now, let us take KVL for mesh 1. A, B, H, F, G, A. So in mesh 1, how many elements are there? 100 volts, 10 ohms, 12 ohms, 10 ohms. There are 4 elements. Is it?
Yes, sir.
First, I will write the skeleton of equation. I1. I2. I3 is equals to. Okay. This is the skeleton of equation. I1, I2 and I3 is equals to. Or, okay. We'll manage. Now, if you are in mesh 1, keep the coefficient of I1 as positive. If you are in mesh 1, it is, if you are in mesh 1 and I1 is the current. If you are in mesh 2, I2 is the current. Mesh 3, I3 is the current. So, while writing KVL for mesh 1, keep the coefficient is flowing in 10 ohms. Okay? Take the sum of all the resistors of mesh 1. Did you get the point? Observe the mesh 1 of the circuit. Keep the coefficient sign of the mesh 1 current, that is I1, positive. Then the coefficient of I1 is nothing but the sum of all the resistors of mesh 1. 10 plus 12 plus 10, that is 32. Don't worry, don't believe it blindly. We will cross check it. Now, when I am writing equation for mesh 1, the coefficient of I2 and I3, you take negative. Okay? If you are writing equation for mesh 1, only the coefficient of I1 should be positive, I2 and I3 should be negative. If you are writing equation for mesh 2, coefficient of I2 should be positive, I1 and I3 should be negative. Okay. Now, which is the common element between mesh 1 and mesh 2?
12 ohms.
12 ohms. Coefficient of I2 is 12 ohms. Which is common element between mesh 1 and mesh 3?
10 ohms.
10 ohms. Coefficient of I3 will be 10 ohms. Then what is RHS? RHS is the EMF value of the mesh. Now observe, what is the direction of 100 volts? It is upwards. Positive terminal is upward, means direction of EMF is also upward. Is it? Positive terminal of voltage source is upward, means direction of that EMF source is also upward. Now equal to, if the direction of EMF source and the direction of current are same, you take positive. If the direction of EMF and the direction of current are opposite, you take negative. Now I1 is flowing in clockwise. So when it is flowing in clockwise, when it passes through 100 volt source, it is flowing upward from G to A. The direction of 100 volts is also from G to A. The direction of rise in potential is also from G to A. So direction of voltage source and direction of current are same. Therefore, it is plus 100 volts. This is equation 1. Okay? Understood?
Yes, sir.
First, identify the measures. Then write I1, I2, I3. Okay? We know how many measures are there. So many equations I will get. If there are only two measures, write I1 and I2. That's it. Write I1, I2 and I3. Then if you are writing equation for mesh 1, then keep the sign of I1 positive. Then sign of I2 and I3 negative. Then for I1, add all the resistors of mesh 1. That is the coefficient of I1. For I2, the common resistor between mesh 1 and mesh 2 is the coefficient. For I3, common resistor between mesh 1 and mesh 3 is the coefficient of I3. Equal to voltage source, direction of voltage and direction of current, if they are same, that mesh current, if they are same, then it is positive. If direction of current is opposing the direction of voltage, it is minus. Suppose there are multiple sources, effective value of two sources. If there is another source in the same mesh, so RHS will be effective value. This is nothing but sum of all the higher drops equal to sum of all the EMFs. This is the fundamental equation of KVL. Sorry, expression, definition of KVL. Now we will write the KVL equation using our conventional method, what we did in the previous two examples. Now mark the polarities. Plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. It is there already. Plus, minus, plus, minus. Now, as per the previous method, you tell me the equation. Direction of I1 is along the direction of rise in potential of 100 volts. From G to A, current is flowing. From G to A, potential is rising. So this is plus 100. Voltage drop. I1 is flowing through 10 ohms. Minus 10 into I1. I'm in mesh 1. Current in 12 amps is I1 as well as I2. So in mesh 1, it is I1 minus I2. So it is minus 12 I1 minus I2. I'm in mesh 1. Between mesh 1 and mesh 3, 10 ohms is there. So minus 10 I1 minus I3 is equals to 0. Now open the brackets. 100. Minus 10 I1, minus 12 I1, plus 12 I2, minus 10 I1, plus 10 I3 is equals to 0. Or I can write 100 minus 32 I1, minus 10 minus 10 minus 20, minus 12 minus 32 I1. Plus 12 I2 plus 10 I3 is equals to 0. Or what I can write? 32 I1 minus 12 I2 minus 10 I3 is equals to 100. Now, is there any change between equation 1 and equation A? Yes?
No.
No. So, it means that what I inspection I followed is correct. Is it?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Now, for mesh 2. It is Is it visible clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now we'll write KVL for mesh 2. Okay, what is that? BCDHB. I will write the skeleton of equation. I1, I2, I3 is equals to. Tell me the coefficient of I1. Now we are in mesh 2, therefore the coefficient of I2 should be positive, coefficient of I1 should be negative, coefficient of I3 should be negative. So for the coefficient of I1 is nothing but the common element between mesh 2 and mesh 1, which is nothing but my, what is the common element between mesh 2 and mesh 1?
12 ohms.
So it is minus 12. I2 is flowing in all the elements of mesh 2. It means it is flowing in all the resistors of mesh 2. So sum of all the resistor values, 10 plus 12 plus 10, that is 32. Okay. Now in mesh 3, the common element between mesh 2 and mesh 3, okay, is 10 ohms again. Therefore, the coefficient of I3 will be minus 10 equals to. Now what is the voltage source in the mesh 2? It is 50 volts. Direction of voltage source is from C to D. Direction of current through voltage source is also from C to D. Therefore, it is plus 50. See, direction of 50 is from C to D. Direction of I2 is also from C to D. Therefore, equals to plus 50. This is equation 2. Then what about KVL for mesh 3? So mesh 3 is what? H, D, E, F, H. Again, write I1, I2 and I3. Now, which is the positive current in this equation? I'm in mesh 3. Therefore, the current of mesh 3 is I3. That should have positive coefficient. Whereas, the coefficient of I1 and I2 will be negative. Okay. Are you getting this?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is coefficient of I1? It is the resistor that is common between mesh 1 and mesh 3. What is that?
10 ohm.
It is minus 10 ohm. Coefficient of resistor between mesh 2 and mesh 3. It is also 10 ohm.
10 ohm.
Minus 10 ohm. So coefficient of I3 is the resistor into which I3 is flowing in mesh 3, that is sum of all the resistors of mesh 3, 10 plus 10 plus 24. How much it is?
44.
Equals to. How many EMF sources are there in the mesh 3?
Zero.
There is no EMF source in mesh 3, hence it is zero. You please write fundamental equations for mesh 2 and mesh 3 and check whether you are getting the same. Okay?
Yes, sir, same.
Okay, you should get the same. Now solving equation 1, 2 and 3?
Yes, sir.
Solving 1, 2 and 3. I1 is equals to I2 is equals to, but actually we are interested in the current through 24 ohms. The question asked is to find the current through 24 ohms. Is it? So yes, please read the question in the exam. What is given? You find only that much. Don't do everything. Yeah. What is I3?
2.20 amps.
2.209 amps. Positive?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is I1?
5.42 amps.
I2?
4.28 amps.
Okay. So it means that the directions what we have assumed in all the three meshes, it is correct. Right? So this is how to write the equations you just by inspection. Okay. Once you get practice to write the equations using inspection method, just by seeing the circuit, you will write three equations and you will put those equations in the calculator, you will solve it. Less than 2 minutes is required. Any clarifications you need on this?
No, sir. Clear, sir.
It's clear, okay? So please have a practice on these two examples what we have done today, okay? You can take any different values and solve. If you change one register value, it will become a new example, okay? So you can have any combination. Please remember, to get through this subject, practice is the only rescue. You cannot read the examples, you cannot remember them, you cannot by heart them. Only practice, only practice, only practice. Okay. So with this, we'll end this session.